Attorney General Ken Cuccinelli has decided to stay out of a Supreme Court case that pits the family of a fallen Iraqi soldier against the controversial Westboro Baptist Church. Cuccinelli did not sign on to an amicus brief filed by 49 other attorneys general in support of the family of Matthew Snyder. And joining us to discuss Cuccinelli's decision is Delegate Ward Armstrong. He's the Virginia House Minority Leader. Armstrong joins us via Skype from Martinsville, and it is his birthday. So thank you for joining us on your birthday.
Thank you, Ryan. It's good to be with you this afternoon.
Now tell us, do you think that the Attorney General's made a mistake in this case?
Oh, absolutely. For families that made the ultimate sacrifice, losing a child, their privacy and their rights to bury that child certainly ought to be protected. We're one of only two states that have not joined into this particular lawsuit, and I find that inexcusable. Go ahead, Ryan.
Well, Mr. Cuccinelli is arguing that this kind of speech is protected by the First Amendment. He actually has the support of many First Amendment groups, including the ACLU, which is certainly not a conservative group by any stretch of the imagination. Why do you think that this form of free speech, or this form of speech, I should say, is not protected by the First Amendment?
I'm a staunch believer in the First Amendment, don't get me wrong, but we don't let people yell fire in a crowded theater. We don't allow people to go in and disrupt a teacher who's teaching in the classroom. I mean, we don't allow cigarette ads on television. All of those are forms of speech, but there are some types of speech that we think should be regulated. And that's what I'm saying here, is that I just don't think that allowing someone to interrupt a funeral is the type of speech that that should be unfettered. I don't think that we should be allowing that, and he should have joined in the lawsuit.
Now, one of the other things the Attorney General said is that there are already existing laws on the books in Virginia that would prevent these type of protests from interrupting a funeral like this. Do you agree with that opinion?
Well, I was one of the proponents of the legislation that we passed in Virginia. There's nothing wrong with strengthening those laws wherever we can. And just because we have a statute in Virginia does not mean that in other places that this would be accepted. But in any event, he needs to stand up, though, for what I think mainstream Virginians believe, that we shouldn't be allowing these funerals to be interrupted. I'm very disappointed that the Attorney General has chosen not to represent most Virginians on this issue.
Now, you mentioned today in a conference call with reporters that he is only representing a right-wing fringe in the Commonwealth of Virginia. This isn't necessarily a right-wing perspective. Why do you think that this falls into the same camp with some of the other actions that Cuccinelli has made?
Well, he certainly didn't hesitate to go after free speech at the University of Virginia professor when he subpoenaed his research records. I mean, I think the Attorney General picks and chooses his fights based on his own personal political agenda. He needs to be reminded that he was elected to represent 7 million Virginians. And clearly, I think if you talk to most Virginians, they would say that interrupting a funeral of a service person is inappropriate and that he ought to do everything he can to try to stop it.
All right. Delegate Ward Armstrong joining us from Martinsville today. Thank you for being here, sir.
Brian, thank you.